Tudo bom, pessoal? Hoje trouxe a Cris aqui, fiz um convite especial para ela, porque nós estávamos conversando nesse final de semana e chegamos a uma informação. Ela me trouxe um monte de informação sobre essa questão da proposta de Joe Biden para 1,7 trilhão de dólares. Isso que foi barrado algumas vezes, está tendo aí um monte de conflitos internos políticos, inclusive dentro do próprio Partido Democrata, e agora existe essa possibilidade do gasto de 100 bilhões de dólares para a imigração. O que que isso vai impactar, né? O que que vai acontecer? Quais são essas cotas de green cards que acabaram ficando aí e se não entrarem para a previsão do ano que vem, vão ser perdidas, vão ser jogadas fora e são pessoas que já tiveram aí processos aprovados. Então, vamos lá. Chris, thank you very much again. Welcome.
Thank you, Daniel. It's great to be here again.
Thank you very much. So, Chris, can you tell them a little bit more about this $1.7 trillion that Biden is trying to spend or trying to approve, and this $100 billion for immigration, please?
Yes. So this is Plan C, because as audiences know, the Biden administration has tried to do previous plans, but it was trying to do too much for undocumented workers, a pathway to citizenship. So now people are saying, how about we stick to legal immigration, which would be great. You know, let's get people who are legally approved to get their visas to come to the U.S. And so this $100 billion is to capture that portion of the population, legal immigration. What do they want to do? They want to try to put money into USCIS to get rid of the backlog. And more importantly, to use the visas that are there for people who have been approved, and it's about 226,000 of them that they want to get used. Because if it's not used, it will be lost. Of that number, probably 150,000 are family-based and more than 80,000 are employment-based, which I think is very, very important. There are so many people in the employment-based category that need to come to the U.S. to provide jobs in crucial infrastructure areas that employers need and to contribute to create more jobs and to stimulate the economy. So this is something that everybody is sort of on board with, Democrats and Republicans, because it's part of legal immigration. So now the question is going to become, will the parliamentarian agree that this $100 billion meets the reconciliation budget rules of the Senate?
Yes. Well, and at this time, at this moment, I believe that bringing more workers to the United States will, you know, make a huge difference for the economy. What do you think?
Absolutely. I think in every industry, employers just don't have enough employees for anything. And that could mean professional, skilled, unskilled. Everybody needs more workers to be able to provide services for their industry. And there's a couple of different things going on, but I think the pandemic resulted in many Americans kind of reevaluating their lives about what they want to do. And as it was before the pandemic, there was already a shortage. And now with everyone sort of leaving what they thought they wanted to do, but now they don't want to do, employers can't find employees. If you go to restaurants, they're everyone's short staffed. You go into retail, everyone is short staffed. And so it's counterproductive to what the Biden administration wants to do for an economic stimulus. But where do we go to kind of address that? And that would be the employment-based immigration, people who can legally immigrate. And now it's skilled, unskilled, and professionals.
And what about the DACA program?
Yes. So that will be part of the program. And it's going to go to address kids who came here, you know, in 2010. They were trying to expand it to millions more in terms of being able to provide citizenship. But with what the parliamentarian said, they don't want new policy to be created, but to work within the framework of the legislation that allows legalization of undocumented workers. So there's a pathway to a green card, not necessarily to a citizenship.
Oh, good. Okay. Thank you very much, Chris.
Thank you, Daniel.
That's news for everybody. Gente, eu acredito que com certeza esclareceu bastante coisa aqui para vocês. Muita gente estava querendo saber como é que seria isso. Esse backlog na imigração, ele realmente criou um caso, criou um caos, na verdade, muito grande, aí onde as pessoas tiveram. Muita gente ficou esperando, muitas pessoas estão esperando, essas entrevistas, o agendamento das entrevistas, a concessão dos green cards. Se Deus quiser, dessa vez agora vai. E essa proposta agora faz muito mais sentido do que todas as demais. Então a gente realmente acredita que ela deva ser aprovada. Grande abraço a todos. Chris, thank you very much. It's a pleasure having you here.
Thanks, Daniel. We'll see you next time.
Fiquem com Deus. Um abraço. Obrigado.